Isaiah chapter 22, 22nd book of the Bible, is the Song of Solomon. The burden. We've been talking about burdens. Of the valley of vision. Matthew 24, 16. I got a note. What aileth thee now that thou art wholly gone up to the housetop? Now, something's going on. What they would do, they would run on top of the house. They're flat houses. And you look. Jesus speaks about, you know, when the time, the abomination of desolation speaks to him that's on the housetop, let him not go down in the house, get out, go, run. So we're looking at the tribulation again. Thou art full of stir, a tumultuous city. The stir is, you know, not stirring your coffee, is, you know, it's just, there's trouble, there's anxiety, there's unknowing what's going on. A joyous city, thy slain men are not slain with the sword, nor dead in battle. I mean, if you're a soldier, you die in battle, that's some kind of honor. But tumultuous and slain men, not because of war. So whatever comes is not war, is not an enemy. Troops, army, all thy rulers, the government, are fled together. Nice government. Trouble, I'm out of here, bye. Imagine in America, and, you know, this kind of trouble comes up, and you go to Washington, D.C., and you know, all you hear is crickets. They're all loud. And wouldn't that be talk? Where's all the senators? Where's all the Republicans? Where's the president? Oh, he's never around anyway. But where's the senators? Where are they all? Why did they leave? What's going on? That would leave the people in panic. And what's going on? They run on top of their houses. It'd be a mass confusion. And there'd be, who do you turn to for protection? If the leaders are gone, they're not looking out for you. They are bound, chained, tied by the archers. Well, archers are part of an army. All that are found in thee are bound, tied up, handcuffed, chained together, which have fled from which have fled far. Well, in the time that Nebuchadnezzar took over Jerusalem, which is not this time here, but Nebuchadnezzar's army caught the king of Israel, the king of Judah, when he fled. He's on the run. He's out of the city. The ruler is out of the city, is caught, and you turn around and look back, and there's a city full of people, and they don't know what's going on. They have no authority. You know, it is said that the captain should go down with his sheep. The ruler should go down with the country, with the city, or whatever it is. In America, it's funny, even with George Washington. George Washington, the presidents are the commanders in chief of the military. And yet not one president in any war has stepped down off the Oval Office on the battlefield. They send out the armies, they send out the Marines, they send out the Air Force, they send out the Navy, they send out the Coast Guard, but yet they don't go themselves. Now, I understand George Washington, and I understand a lot of the presidents were military men. I understand that. But David, military captains and leaders of Israel went to war and were on the battlefields with the men and his sons. King Saul died with his sons right by his side. You know, it's not like, okay, we're going to start a war, and I'm going to put my children, you know, in another country away from the war. No, in the Bible, listen, the rule of the nation, the king and his children were right there fighting too. David took a day off from a war, and look what happened. You know, things would change his country in Iraq, the recent war in Afghanistan we're fighting right now, if Bush had gone into war himself with his children. I wonder how, what if he really would made that maneuver? Any president, would he make that move to declare war with Congress approval if he has to go there himself? That'd be a different story when you gotta go. Therefore said I, Isaiah, look away from me. I will weep bitterly. Labor not to comfort me because of the spoiling of the daughters of my people. Jews. For it is a day of trouble and treading down, being stumbled by horses, Revelation 6, a perplexed by the Lord God of hosts in the valley of vision, breaking down the walls and crying to the mountains. It's a city. And Elam bare the quiver, that's what you hold your arrows in, with chariots of men and horsemen, and Kerr uncovereth the shield. Battle, army. And shall come to pass that thy choice is valleys shall be full of chariots. And if you remember David and Goliath, do you remember what the picture was there? Here's a valley with two mountains. The Philistines were on one mountain, and Israel was on the other mountain. And Goliath would come down into the valley and cry out, come on, bring one of your men. They fought in valleys. Valley is a plain where they come down off the mountains into the valley and fight. And valleys, it's a bad place to be, because if you're in a valley fighting, those who are on the mountain have the advantage. As you climb up that mountain, they're shooting things down at you and rolling things down at you. You want to be on the mountaintop. In a valley, you got to climb. Shall be full of chariots and horsemen shall set themselves in array at the gate. That's not to be entering into a gate of peace, but you know, how you doing? I got some stuff to trade. This is, we're going to destroy you. And he discovered the covering of Judah. He's made Judah known, opened her up. And now, I mean, if you see in someone's backyard, he's got a cover over it. What is that? What's he got? And the wind catches just right and it starts flapping. Oh, look, you've got a boat back there. He's got an old car. Now I know what he's got. Thou didst look in that day to the armor of the house of the forest. Now remember, Solomon built all these places, armories. This is what this is. This is an armory. This is a building that is off somewhere and it would have the weaponry of the soldiers. So if you're going to battle, you would stop at this building, you would pick up what you need, and go on. You didn't have to carry it the whole way. Or if you happen to be fighting in that area, well, here's this armory. Stop in and get what you need. You have seen also the breaches, and that's a broken rupture of the city of David. Oh, there we go. Zion. That they are many. There are many broken, ruptured parts of the wall. And ye gather together the waters of the lower pool. You're making reservoirs so you can drink. Ye have numbered the houses of Jerusalem And the houses have ye broken down to fortify the wall. You imagine the guy, he's sitting there, he's with his wife and children having dinner, next thing you know, the troops come in and they tear his house down. What are you doing? You gotta fix the wall. With my house? You don't have a supply if you're using the guy's house. You don't have a standby lumber and timber and rocks and all that. You gotta use someone's house. You're not ready for this. Ye made also a ditch between the two walls for the water of the old pool. Again, you need supply of water. But ye have not looked unto the maker thereof, neither had respect on him that fashioned it long ago. Hezekiah. Go back and read about Hezekiah. You're just trying to protect yourselves. You're not thinking about nothing. You're destroying. You destroyed a man's livelihood, his house, because the walls are broken down. You didn't protect the city. And in that day, the Lord God of hosts called to weeping and to mourning and to baldness. Some anxieties, some diseases will cause you to be bald. They could be shaving their heads for gods, worship of gods. When Joseph went before Pharaoh, you had to shave yourself. I mean, he was the God King. And to girding with sackcloth. We're in desperate anxiety here. We are in trouble. And behold, joy and gladness, slaying oxen, killing sheep, eating flesh, and drinking wine. Why on earth? Wait a minute. I thought there was sadness. I thought there was trouble. I thought there was problems. Let us eat and drink, for tomorrow we shall die. What an attitude. When the walls are broken down, people's houses are being destroyed. You gotta build ditches to save water, and these people. And look what the Lord says. Thus saith the Lord God of hosts. Go get thee. Did I? 14. I knew something was wrong. And it was revealed in my ears by the Lord of hosts. Surely this iniquity shall not be purged from you till ye die. Behold, joy, gladness, slaying an oxen, killing sheep. That wasn't for the Lord. That wasn't to get right to the Lord. They're just having parties. You know, troops have been killed recently. And all they've been doing in Washington, D.C. is having parties. How many inauguration balls and expensive money has been since we went into Afghanistan and Iraq? How many troops have been killed? And then how many times have you ever heard from the war? Now, maybe old history, because I don't do American history well. But how many times have you heard a president of the United States call into his banquet house, whatever that room is called, the dining room, and sit down at his table, men and women of the military who have fought overseas, and have that president say, for this entire year, whatever, how many months it takes, I am going to sit at my table, every single person who's over Afghanistan, and every single person that's over Iraq, they're going to sit with me at my table, because I'm going to thank them. No! The President of the United States that brings in all the bigwigs, all the ambassadors, all the big shots. You know, your tax money pays for Washington, D.C. You imagine walking up to the White House and inviting yourself. No, you can't even walk up to the White House. They're not going to let you in. But if you're some rap singer or some kind of movie star, you know, you can get the red carpet. I mean, they have tours through. I bet you they charge you for the tour. I could be wrong. I don't know. But I don't want to tour the White House. I want to sit down and tell the president what things I think and how I think about how he's run the country. And for him to listen to me. And every single taxpaying person in the United States should have that opportunity. Every taxpayer in the United States should have the opportunity to sleep one night in the White House that we paid for. That's just, these people are partying, having a good old time, and the city's destroyed. People's houses are being destroyed. Their lives are destroyed. And God says, your iniquity shall not be purged from you till you die. And they'll end up in hell, burning. They are in hell today. Thus saith the Lord God of hosts, go, get thee unto this treasurer, even unto Shibna, which is over the house, and say, all right, here is a treasurer of the city. Go to him, Isaiah. What hast thou here? And whom hast thou here? That thou hast hewed thee out a sepulcher here. This guy is in the treasury, and God tells Isaiah, walk in and say, what is this place you got here? Who is here? This guy has made his own little dwelling place, inviting his own little people where he ought not to be. This is the same thing that happened to Nehemiah. Nehemiah. He goes away, and the guy sets up his own little fortress in the temple. And he's got to boot this guy out, clean the place up. He could be at the temple too. As he that heweth him out a sepulcher on high, look who I am. Joseph of Arimathea, yeah, he was a rich man and he hewed out his own sepulcher, but he gave it to Jesus. He gave it to Jesus so the scripture could be fulfilled and that no one could say, you know, because that sepulcher was able to be sealed and have a troop watching it. This guy, he does it for himself and everything for himself. And that graveth an habitation for himself in a rock. The type of bomb shelter. This guy knows destruction's coming, so what's he do? He goes builds himself a fortified place with his own family and his own friends. The treasurer. He ain't thinking about the people. Their houses are gone. Behold, the Lord will carry thee away, the treasurer, with a mighty captivity, and will surely cover thee. I don't know what the cover means. I guess you can't go anywhere. You can't see anything. Maybe death. God will surely violently turn and toss thee like a ball into a large country. Boing, 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 boing. Wherever it goes. Wherever it ends up. No purpose. There shalt thou die. And there the chariots of thy glory. I go, look at that. He's got his own little glory chariots. He's got, you know, he's got big fancy limousines and a car for every day of the week. Shall be the shame of thy Lord's house. Did you hear about Shibna? Yeah, you see that chariot he got? Yeah, man, check that chariot out. Did it help him in the time of the invasion? No, it didn't. It was just for show. The guy builds a chariot and couldn't help defend himself. That'd be like a guy who's got a house full of guns that doesn't know how to use them. Look at that guy. And when they came, he couldn't even protect his family. Gives him a name of a laughing stock. And I, God, will drive thee from thy station, where he's put. You know, a train station is a place where the train stops. A man in the military, he's stationed. That's where he needs to stay. Anywhere else, he's absent without leave. From thy state shall be pulled, and from thy state shall he pull thee down. Not up, down. You don't want to go down. You want to go up. He is on high. He built himself a high place. He's got this high chariot. Now he's going down, down, down into the pit of hell. And shall come to pass in that day, I will call my servant. Here's a servant of God. There are men that God says are my servants. Nebuchadnezzar is one of them. Cyrus is another. Elkiam, the son of Hakiel. He's named. He's given the name of his father. 2 Kings 18:18, I got a note there. I will clothe him with thy robe. And strengthen him with thy girdle. And I will commit thy government into his hand. And he shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem and to the house of Judah. That's interesting. Here's this guy that God calls out. And he's going to be put in the authority of the government wearing this guy, this other guy's clothes. I can't say any more much about it. This guy's a type of Christ. The key of the house of David, Jewish, will I lay upon his shoulders. So he shall open, and the prophecy looks to Jesus Christ, Revelation chapter 3, verse 7. This guy is a type of Christ amongst the city being destroyed. Now here's this guy that shows up. And he's going to rule over the nation. And he's called my servant by God. And none shall shut. Isn't that what it said in the Philadelphia church age? And he shall shut, and none shall open. Isn't that the Laodicean church age? The Philadelphia church age, there's an open door. No man's going to shut. The Laodicean church age, there's Jesus standing at the door knocking. And no one really opens the door. He says, if any man but this door here, whoever opens and whoever shuts, you ain't going to reverse what he does. In the Laodicean church age, the Lord knocks on the door, a man has opportunity to open it and come to the Lord. I don't think the Lord steps in. He doesn't want to be in the mess of the church. There have been a lot of churches I've walked out of and not returned to because of the mess that's going in. I will fasten him as a nail in a sure place. Second Advent. And he shall be for a glorious throne to his father's house. Who is his father? God. Not Elohim. But if it's type of Jesus Christ. And they shall hang upon him a nail on a wall. Will you hang upon that nail? They shall hang upon him all the glory of his father's house. The offspring and the issue, their children. All vessels of small quality, from the vessels of cups, even to all the vessels of flagons. And there were vessels in that in the tabernacle, in the temple, used to do service to God. Laying all the burdens and all the sacrifices upon the Lord Jesus Christ. And in that day, saith the Lord of hosts, shall the nail that is fastened in the sure place be removed, crucified, rejected, sit at the right hand of the Father now, and only those who believe on the Lord Jesus Christ as their Savior allowed to come in. Many Jews are going to hell today because they have not believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, even though they are God's people. And those in the millennium who do not follow the Lord. Listen, the opportunity is to go jump in the lake. What's the other opportunity? When Satan is loose, what does Satan do? He gathers an army. But this nail being a type of Christ, Elohim, Jesus Christ, he is rejected. He is despised, Isaiah 53, when we get to that. There's no common, there's no form of beauty that we desire him. They said, give us Barabbas, give us the Roman government, and be cut down and fall. Christ didn't fall. And the burden that was upon it shall be cut off. The offspring, the issue, the vessels of small quality, the vessels of cup, the vessels of flagon, mentioned in verse 24. What's that mean? I don't know. But I know one thing, for the Lord has spoken it, and what the Lord speaks will come to be. Clues right there.